गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन. एंड एज वी ऑल नो दैट वी हैव स्टार्टेड विद चैप्टर नंबर 18, दैट इज लाइफ इन द डेजर्ट रीजन्स. एंड वी इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट सहारा डेजर्ट, एंड हेयर वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट लद्दाख विच इज इन इंडिया. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, वॉट इज द फिजिकल बेस ऑफ लद्दाख इज हेयर यू कैन सी दैट लद्दाख इज लाइंग इन द ईस्टर्न साइड ऑफ जम्मू एंड कश्मीर. हेयर यू कैन सी इट इज लद्दाख. And it is also called as the rain shadow area because you know this is the area which receives no rainfall. It is bounded by Karakoram range over here and Zaskar mountains over here, and here you will find you know Kargil. So this is the location of Ladakh. It is a cold mountainous rocky desert, and here the average altitude is about 6000 meters. So this is a place which is on very high altitude. Here, you know, in Jammu and Kashmir, you know, the river Indus flows, and many tributaries, you know, like Nubra, Shyok, Suru and Zanskar, they actually dissect the, you know, the rugged mountain terrain. And Pangong So is one huge saltwater lake in Ladakh. Talking about the climate, the rainfall here is very low. It is less than 10 centimeter. As I told you that it is a rain shadow area, that is why. Again, sometime due to external disturbances in the winter, season, sometimes what happens is that it receives little bit of snowfall into the Jammu and Kashmir area, and that is why it feeds the glaciers of the mountains. Now what is westerly disturbances? Westerly disturbance means that the winds, moisture laden winds which come from the western side, from the Mediterranean Sea, they actually, you know, come and enter into India, and they bring rainfall into the northwest India, and they bring snow into these cold areas. So these are called as westerly disturbances. After that, Khardungla is actually the pass which actually helps in crossing the Tibet. The temperature in summer is as high as 30 degrees Celsius and as low as minus 3 degrees Celsius. But when we talk about the winter season, then we can see that in winters, the temperature remains below freezing point, and at night, sometime it is as low as minus 35 degrees Celsius. Then we are going to talk about the natural vegetation of Ladakh. Then actually the natural vegetation of Ladakh is, you know, almost barren. They do not have any tall trees, but you know, in the some of the down slopes of the Tibet, you will find some of the trees like willow, cedar, elm, poplar, cypress, juniper and yew trees. These are coniferous trees which are found in mountainous cold areas only. During the summer trips, there are certain trees which bloom, like for example apple, apricot and walnut. And in alpine pastures, you will find some mosses and gentians over here. Talking about the wildlife, here you know in wildlife you will not find much, but you know only those kind of animals survive over here which have a very thick, you know, skin, and they can survive to the harsh climate, like york. And you know there is goat, mountain goat and sheep and Tibetan wild ass which is called as yang, and various kind of antelopes and dzong, and some migratory birds also come to this area into the warmer seasons, okay, whenever there is a severe winter in their areas. If we talk about the life of the people, then the Ladakhis are very fiercely independent. They are not dependent upon outside sources, and they are very hardworking. And most of the population of the Tibetan people are actually Tibetan Buddhists. Tibetan Buddhists who actually live here in monasteries over here in Tibet, they live over here. And you know, their spiritual leaders, that is called as Lamas, by the name of Lamas, they also play a very important role in the Ladakhi life. Okay. So these are the people who you know live harmony with the, you know, nature, and they survive even in the harsh climate. Okay, now the economy in Ladakh is actually, you know, dependent upon three things: agriculture, animal rearing and tourism. So, and in animal rearing, there are certain kind of animal which they keep, like for example yak, dzong, sheep and goat. And these actually, you know, animal, you know, provide them with milk, wool and hair. And you know, they feed on the pastures in the summer season, and in the winter season they feed on the stored fodder which they keep into the summer season. During winters, when the people cannot go out, they actually do the most of the weaving work in their home front only, and that is why the wool over here, the Pashmina wool, is very much famous, and even the handicraft of Tibet is very much famous, and that is why a lot of tourists come and shop over here for their handicrafts. Agriculture is also practiced into the summer season, and many fruits and vegetables you can see over here, like peas, turnip, beans, potato, apples, strawberries, apricot, mulberries are grown here. Now, because it is a very dry area, it is a desert area, that is why most of the farmers, they receive water from the melted glaciers. In the summer season, when the glaciers are melting, these are the source of the fresh water for their, agriculture. Tibet handicraft is also very much famous, and because here, the furniture making business is also very good. There, for example, they do knitting and weaving and cabinet making, wood carving, metal work, and all kind of silk paintings and everything, they make into, especially into the winter season when they are living at home only and they do not go out. So that is why the government has organized many cooperative and training institute to train people to make more and more of handicraft, which is very famous. And that is why, tourism is also very much famous in Ladakh, because a lot of people come in, Ladakh, and they actually, visit, especially in the summer season. And that is why here, the handicraft also sells, and handicraft of Ladakh is also very much famous. So, since the 1970s, there have been many road links between Srinagar and Leh, and Manali and Leh have opened up the region considerably and brought many changes over there. So you can see a lot of changes in Ladakh, because previously it was not easily accessible, but now in summer season it is accessible, but in winters it is a very bad situation when it is very difficult to cross Ladakh. So that is a very difficulty level in Ladakh season. So this is about Ladakh. So in this chapter, we have covered both the case studies. One is about the Sahara Desert and another one is about the Ladakh. Thank you so much.